Right then guys, thanks for tuning into the channel. I've not done any filming today at all because once we got off the ferry, the rain has been relentless all day long. So we've been on the motorway for most of it. We've just come to one of the places I wanted to visit in a little village called L'Aglise. So we've arrived here in the rain, we've had a little look around the museum, and the reason we've come here is to have a look at this piece of kit here. I think you'll find this is quite impressive really. The story behind it is that this tank came into the village and the barrel was hit and it got damaged by the Americans. So it ended up staying here for the rest of the war. And at the end of the war, when the Americans came to take it away for scrap, one of the local ladies in the village said to the Yanks, I want that tank, I want it to stay here. So they said, well, what are you gonna give us for it? So she said, a bottle of cognac. And the deal was done. Well, there you go. That's a king tiger, that behind you. Let's go and have a look around it. This thing is massive. Look at the lynx on the track here. How big they are. See where it's been hit a few times. I say about a third of the barrel was taken off. So this must be either a replacement or what. We made one just for it, just for show. King tiger. What a beast. I think it's about 70 tons. It's huge. I was going to climb over it, but I thought they might say, hey, get off. What a piece of kit. And that was its number, that 213 was its actual number. Yeah. Little village called L'Aglise in Belgium. And a tidy museum as well. £16, I think it was, converted. It's got loads of equipment in there. I'll put some pictures on at the end of the video of all the stuff that's in there. Loads been dug up, and it's guns, machine guns, uniforms, helmets, everything, ammunition. Anyway, I'm off. It's raining. So this is the Malmedy Massacre Memorial, and there was 80 odd American soldiers caught in this area by Joachim Peiper. He was an SS tank commander, very infamous, nasty piece of work, and he basically lined them all up on the other side of this wall and shot them all dead, and then they buried them in the snow. I think they were engineers of some sort. Yeah, you saw the names on here, 80 odd of them, December 1944. So we finally arrived in a very wet Cockum in Germany from Rotterdam. Not stopped raining all day long. Even the Gore-Tex gave up, didn't it? Everything. But we're here. Beautiful castle on top there. Stunning. Really nice place. On the Moselle. It's the Moselle. Let's go and find a couple of bars now, aren't we? For a bevy. Just lovely. Just bloody lovely.
So pretty. Which way was your sat nav originally? Whoa, 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 love. Get so you can see what's coming up road.
That's where it said about the roads. With a diamond there, you have priority. Yeah. Now, some places you'll go, that will be crossed out. So it means if something comes from your right, you have to give way to them. If you don't know about that, you could cause yourself an accident, yeah. But you have priority on this road, yeah. It's a strange idea, but...
A stupid idea, because it doesn't line up with the rest of the bloody world.
One through this lovely little village. Town, even. And a lovely crane as well. Isn't that nice? Oh. I've got the SAS in Land Rover here. Oh well, These are nice bends, these. Oh! Austria!
When it's not always raining, there'll be days like this. When there's no one complaining, there'll be days like this. Everything falls into place like the flick of a switch. Well, my mama told me there'll be days like this. When you don't need to worry, there'll be days like this. When no one's in a hurry, there'll be days like this. When you don't get betrayed by that old Judas kiss. Oh, my mama told me there'll be days like this. When you don't need an answer, there'll be days like this. When you don't need a chance, there'll be days like this. When all the parts of the puzzle start to look like they fit, then I must remember there'll be days like this. Playing tricks when you don't have no freeloaders out to get their kicks. Well, that's nobody's business the way that you want to live. I just have to remember there'll be days like this. When no one steps on my dreams, there'll be days like this. When people understand what I mean, there'll be days like this. When you ring out the changes of how everything is, well, my mama told me there'll be days like this.
Right, another wet, horrible bloody day in Germany. This is 2 out of 3. However, we've come to a location near Fussen, where quite a bit of The Great Escape was filmed. This hut here is exactly where Steve McQueen was stood at the side when the Germans come up this road here. And I know this because I visited the website, which is Great Escape Film Locations, and I've been here before. So he's right on this corner here, he's got his motorbike parked up, leaning against the hut itself, and he's pointing his gun down there where the pylon is, and he's just here, so just there, leaning his bike up against that there, pointing down towards the Germans. Yeah, cracking. And the Great Escape field jump is further down this road on our right. So we'll stop there and have a nosy at that as well. There you go. Piece of history. Last Great Escape location, I promise. So do you remember the three German officers that got out of the car? They came over, there was a bar there, James Colburn was sat here behind his newspaper, we got a drink, telephone rang, James Colburn went over there behind the bar, the resistance pulled up in the car, shot the three German officers. That's exactly here, that's the location. Last one, as I say, I won't bore you anymore, there is plenty more in town, there you go, see you later.
Turn right on Tulliwiportstrasse, then enter the roundabout. British Garden, here we come, yeah, das ist gut. Currywurst mit Pommes, zweimal bitte, lovely Taufussen, highly recommended. Isn't it, Ellen?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Fab.
Fab Tau. Fab Tau. Like I said before, loads of scenes from the Great Escape film, do you? I'll beat you. Train station. Steve McQueen's jump, I'll say the cafe scene where the three German officers were shot, where Bartlett and his the other guy were being chased down through the streets after they had escaped. Loads shot here. And we found most of them last night. Cool.
In half a mile, turn right onto B17.
Climbing up on the German Alpine Straße still. It's a bloody long road, this. Views are stunning. Pity it's a 60k limit.
It is on mute.
Yes.
Might start to see some. Guess where we are today? Kelstein House, Eagle's Nest. Great views there. So we're just going to go through the 124 metre tunnel now, get the lift up to the actual Kelstein House itself, have a mooch, have a beer, have a look round. So, apparently there's 12 people killed building this Eagle's Nest. Hitler only visited it, and I think it was documented about 14 times. He wasn't that happy with it because it was susceptible for lightning strikes, which did happen. So I think it was his mistress, Eva Braun, who used it more than what he did. So I think it was Eva Braun's sister had a wedding or a wedding reception in the Kelstein House itself. So there you go. Today's facts. Not much to see outside, it's just covered in cloud. Can't see nothing. In comparison to last time I came here, we could see everything last time. It was a brilliant view. So we've come inside the main room here, where they used to have the events and, like I say, Eva Braun's wedding and stuff like that. So big fireplace here, which I'll show you in a sec. That was, you say it was donated by Mussolini, but there's been a lot of doubt about that. So make your own mind up. So, but this is the great room. We're about to have something to eat and drink. Have a nosy. This is Hotel Zum Türken, and when Hitler had his place built, which is just around the corner here, he commandeered it, and his SS guards lived in here. Bit of a giveaway as well with the guard hut there. And then at the end of the war, it came back to whoever it was, and they started running it as a family business again, as a hotel. And there's lots of tunnels under there, but over the last few years it's been closed down permanently. Somebody's supposed to have bought it, but as you say, it's all shut up. So I don't know what's happening with it. He certainly knew how to pick his places, didn't he, location wise, all these beautiful mountains and stuff around. And so this was the sentry post there.
That's covered. Rebuilt.
I don't know. That path down there takes you to the what was called the Mooslanerkopf, which is the tea house, which he used to go there virtually every day, have his apple pie and tea or coffee, whatever it was. But that's been taken out by the Allies. They bombed that and got rid of it as well. They don't want it to be a shrine or anything to be a shrine. So, but yeah, walk around the corner now. We'll go up to the remains of the Berghof. Walking up now to the Berghof. There's a sentry post just around the corner, or what's left of the sentry post, just the foundations. So this would have been the driveway where they keep all the cars and everything would have come up. Sure, last time we were here,
but some bricks at the side seem to have disappeared. There we go. So all that's left is the rear retaining wall. And the reason they kept the rear retaining wall is just so that the side of the hill didn't slide down, cause a landslide over the main road. This is it here. Probably have been standing in his front room now. It's what? Much bigger? You are here at the centre of the former Führer's off-limits area. 1928, Hitler rented a small country house here, which he bought in 1933 until 1936, was enlarged to the pompous Berghof. The Berghof was damaged in a British air raid on 25th of April 1945 and set on fire by the Obersalzberg SS a few days later. The US military government ordered the ruin to be blown up in 1952. The only fragment preserved today is the supporting wall at the southern slope. The Obersalzberg was not only Hitler's private country retreat, but also served as the second centre of power of the German Reich, alongside the official capital, Berlin. Hitler spent more than a third of his time in power here. Important political discussions and negotiations were conducted here, and incisive decisions were made which led to the catastrophes of the Second World War and the Holocaust, causing the death of millions. There you go. Hope you enjoyed that.
Day six, just left Purchase Garden on our way to Lake Bled for the night, and then down to Croatia tomorrow. However, on the route today, I've got another little surprise for you. Somewhere else, through another war film, 1960s, with Richard Burton, Clint Eastwood, and Mary Ure, I think her name was. Castle, helicopter, cable car, snow. Any clues? Yeah, that's it. It's the Where Eagles Dare. Oh, funnily enough, there it is, right in front of us. How about that then? Schloss Adler in the film it was, so it's Castle Werfen in real life. So we're going to have a nosy around there for a bit, because last time we came in 2019, we were too late, it was shut. So you're allowed to walk around the grounds and that, and I think there's a bit of history about the film and stuff in there, so I'll take you around there, have a nosy. I can't remember what it is. Has Clint still try to get through that window? Bloody hell. Right, we're parking up here, Helen. Oh, it's busy. Yeah,
turn
it's
left busy. Onto the unpaved road.
There you go, guys.
When possible, make a U-turn.
Remember the courtyard off the film where the helicopter came in and landed and all the German soldiers were there? One of them was that SS one, and he only did like the salute, which was like his arms level. And he looked at him as if to say, yeah. Here it is, Schloss Adler. Lovely little place. Cracking views. Wow, check that out. Hello, Austria. That is stunning. I think we're going over in the field over there shortly, because one of the scenes from The Sound of Music was filmed there. I think we are. Yeah. With a cracking view of this castle from up there.